Good morning, everyone. So glad to see you all. Some of you we haven't seen since New Year, so Happy New Year is to you as well. I think we can do that all the way through January, right? And then we stop. But thank you all for being here. This is a very important meeting. We know that there are some early birds, as well as there will be those that can't make it early will come to our evening, and we will repeat the same information again tonight. So we are going to call our meeting to order, and I am going to ask if Dr. Wyatt would lead us in the pledge. Item 1.2, is that a 2? Yes, 1.2, approval of the agenda.
So moved.
It's been moved and properly seconded. Let's vote. We will vote by voice. We'll start with Mr. Tillman. Aye. Motion carried. Thank you so much. We are now at item 2.1. And this is where the meeting will now turn to our community. You all should have received a green sheet like this. This information, when you come to the podium to speak, we ask that you identify the areas that you are going to be discussing or providing extra input, whether it's in the strength of the district, the greatest needs, the critical issues for the district, the superintendent's desired characteristics. Everything is laid out on there. What you will find is what so far the board has made recommendations as well. And so if you find something that is not there, we ask that you would add that information in your statements as you come forward to the mic. And so when you come forward to the mic, please identify yourself and then identify the areas that you will be speaking on, and we ask that you also please be considerate and mindful of others that the time that they will be speaking. Okay. So at that hello, Mr. Gallo. All right, so we will now begin our comments. Would you like to? Yes.
Madam President, I'm just wondering, are we going to be, writing notes, okay, mm-hmm. So that we have them.
Yes, and Dr.
Hey, Madam President, thank you very much. First of all, I just want to say a huge shout out to our IT department and our communications department. They have been absolutely great to work with in terms of setting up for you today, board. As most of you know, this is an old building that's been completely refurbished lately. All of this technology is brand new, and we're putting it to a completely different test. We've never actually tried to get it to do this before, so I want to thank my staff and communications and IT for getting this done. You can come down to either side. We have a podium here and a podium there. We do have translation services for anybody that needs interpretation of their comments, and all of your comments today will be recorded. You'll see them going up as you're speaking, so we would ask that, again, as Ms. Rogers said, you would identify, I believe, a strength of the district is, I believe a need of the district is, and the superintendent should have the following characteristics. And we're going to, if you can keep your comments fairly brief or easy to record, we're going to be putting them up there as you're speaking. So we'll do our best to keep up with you, and they can line up on both sides and just yes. Have at it. Yes, if we could have Spanish-speaking participants on the north side of the building.
And we will have interpretation.
Mark is right.
So there are two mics. Do you have?
They're interpreting from the back.
Okay. Dr. Flores, did you?
Yes. No más quería decir que los que quieren hablar en español tienen que hablar aquí en este. Por favor.
Right.
They can just line up.
All right, we are ready.
Come on down, as we say.
So you can line up on either side, and we are ready to hear your input.
Solamente tienen que formar una línea si quieren hablar.
And while she's getting ready, just so you know, we will be doing a lot of listening as well as taking notes, so we won't be having a formal dialogue.
My name is Kathleen Valdez, and I just wanted I just wanted to add to the strengths of the district. I put is willing to change, to constantly change to better and meet the needs of the students, families, and staff. That's something that I've noticed that you guys are always willing to take input from the community and are always willing to change your ways and not just stay one way. For the greatest needs under the critical issues, where it says create programs that inspire and engage all students, I was hoping to add bringing back practical electives that will help our students to not only flourish now, but in the future, classes like home economics, budgeting, how to file taxes, things like that. And for characteristics for the superintendent, having a serving heart. Maybe the individual has worked in or volunteered in a school site recently because the schools are constantly changing, and maybe someone who's willing to continue to volunteer as they hold that role so they can kind of see what how each school site runs differently. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Next. Thank you, Mr. Brown. Good to see you.
Good morning, San Bernardino. My name is Hardy Brown. I am the executive director of the Black Voice Foundation, a business here in San Bernardino. I also serve as the county board member representing this particular area, but I get a chance to see districts, all 33 school districts throughout the entire county of San Bernardino. And I want to say how proud I am, one of the board, for being able to take this on as an idea for our students. As a parent in the district, one of the things that I'm really interested in is making sure that we have a superintendent who's looking toward the future. Looking toward the future, at future ideas, new trends that are going to be coming out, very visible within the city, and representing our area well. I think that it's very important to make sure that that the rest of the county understands the city of San Bernardino is one of the largest cities in this area. It's one of the largest districts, and we have great students that come from this area, and we just continue to do the work that we're doing. As far as strengths, I think that we have a number of schools that give very diverse ideas. With the pathway idea, I think that is a great idea that we're working on, and our middle college program is one of my favorites that we continue to grow that particular program. So I will continue to read this and look at some of the other strengths, but I think that we have a number of strengths in the district, but we need someone who can continue to build that voice, not only here within the city, but throughout the entire county and throughout the entire region. Thank you.
Thank you. So again, you do have your sheets in front of you, and I know some of you are looking at that, and we did our best to come up with what we have looked at thus far, but we know that there's more that the community can add. So we invite you to come and share. Okay, we have two coming on both sides. Let's see who gets there first. Hello.
Nancy Sanchez Spears, recently retired district. Not loud enough?
Yes, a little bit, if you pull it.
Closer. Oh, okay. Now I can hear me too. One of the things that we discussed in two different groups on Saturday was access. We appreciate the fact that our current superintendent has been accessible to all stakeholders. That includes parents, teachers, students, and he has been very inclusive, and I think that these are attributes that we want to see in any future selection for superintendent. Someone who is open to ideas, someone who comes with good ideas, but also is open to the ideas of the people. Someone who is accessible to listening to individuals, which Dr. Marsden has been uniquely able to do that. I've seen people catch him in the hall, and he'll take time to speak with them. or say, let's make an appointment, but he never ignores a person. I think that's very important because the community needs to feel that whoever the superintendent is here for the community, not just for him or herself. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. My name's Tammy Ford. I'm one of the directors of SOAR Charter Academy. Starting with the strengths, we feel a strength is that continued growth when working with the charter schools within the city. We've been in operation for 12 years and feel that it's been a steady positive growth and positive relationship within the district, and change is going to bring the need for growth on both sides as well, and we feel the district is strong in that area. Desired characteristics, we would like the new superintendent to have the strength to be open-minded while collaborating with charter schools, as well as someone who acknowledges the need for choice to meet the needs and the goals of each individual student that resides within the city and chooses a charter school as a choice for their education. So we're just basically hoping the district keeps in mind that SOAR and all charters within the district are here for the better good of the students and would like to work with the new superintendent in keeping communication and relationships open while educating all the students in this area. Thank you.
Thank you. We invite speakers to come forward at this time. Again, you can read through what's in front of you on the green sheet if you have that, if you pick that up at the front. And if there is something missing, we ask that you provide input. Welcome, Rabbi.
Good morning to all of you. First of all, I want to commend you for these three areas that I think are magnificently developed. You've hit on the real strengths of the district and the needs and the characteristics. There's hardly anything that really needs to be added. So I want to thank all of you on behalf of the community for that. If I were to add anything, it would be to that third area about the desired characteristics. And before doing that, I want to say I think we all owe a tremendous debt of gratitude and also a sense of criticism to Dr. Marsden. He set a standard that is going to be very, very difficult to reach. And, you know, that's your job. But the one thing I would add is that I think the new superintendent needs to understand that San Bernardino suffers from a very, unfortunately, negative self-image. Needs to work with the wider community in developing a more positive self-image, much of which is determined by the success of the school district. That's such an important component of the community, and yet not a, a PR or naive kind of understanding, but rather one based on reality. I think we've been treated to that in a very real way by Dr. Marsden. I would hope that that's something that you would look for in the new superintendent. It's possible that the superintendent will come from outside the district, possibly from inside the district. Those who come from the outside will have to recognize that we in San Bernardino are often, not intentionally, but often our own worst enemies, and that we need to have a positive, much more positive self-image, and much of that can be done in cooperation with the superintendent and the school board and the entire school district. Thank you.
Thank you. For those, I know that there are individuals that are walking in, so I'll repeat again that there is a form up in the front as you walk in, a green form that has three sections. And in each section, we have already gave some of our input. And what we're asking for you to do is identify what may be missing and speak to that so we can include that in our journey to looking for our superintendent. And your information is being captured in real time. So we invite our next speakers to come forward.
Hi, good morning. My name is Kiana Maldonado. I'm a field rep with Supervisor Josie Gonzalez. I was looking through this list, and there was just so much on here that I think is incredibly important. One thing I did want to emphasize in the critical issues is perhaps a superintendent that supports vocational trainings. I think college readiness is extremely important for those students who want to go to college, but for those who want to maybe go in manufacturing or any other technical trainings, maybe support for some more vocational training would be excellent. Thank you.
Thank you. We didn't mean to make it this difficult for you all, but you are correct. You are correct. We do know the needs, and we are a pretty tight group that make sure that, you know, we are considering our community, our students, our staff, everyone. Your voice is important, and looks like we've done a decent job thus far, but please don't hesitate. This is the time. Again, as I said, we will do this evening again for those that were not able to make it this morning. But your voice is important because we are making a very important decision, and we want to make sure that we get it right. All right, come on down.
I'm Rochelle Capozio. I'm chief steward for substitute teachers in our district. And I've been working here for many years. I went to San Bernardino Dual Schools when I was growing up, which is a long time ago. So one of the things that I'm concerned about, I think it should go under greatest needs, critical issues for the district. The last demographics that I saw were for the 18-19 school year. And I think the new superintendent, whether male or female, needs to go in with an accurate set of demographics. I know that we have done a really good job with Hispanic students. I've seen that grow over my lifetime. I think we are now at about 74% Hispanic. And my concern is that I feel that some of the other groups are being marginalized. And I would like to, I think it would be something to consider going in. What are the situations and the opportunities for, I think there's four or five other groups. Okay, that's my concern.
Thank you. Thank you.
Please don't hesitate to come and give input. Nothing's too big and nothing's too small. It does make a difference.
Morning. My name is Esteban Diaz.
Morning.
And I want to comment on what I think are the strengths of the district, and that's the great variety of programs that the district has developed to address all of the diversity of needs and of people, students in the district. I really commend you on that. And I think that we need to find superintendent who has had successful experience in working with diverse socioeconomic and multicultural communities. I think that the biggest need is going to be, up and think about it, with the high schoolers. I think there is an importance to target students who are only 4 years away from going into a very, very hard world. So I would encourage the superintendent to have an experience that really ranges K-12, but that understands K-12 in a deep, serious way so that they can really look at programs like AVID and AP and Baccalaureate and the Pathways program that you have. Excellent. Because it leads to it gives people options. So I would encourage that the new superintendent, whoever that might be, really come prepared to reflect the community of students that is here and to strengthen whatever diversity lends itself to him or her. And since I think, this is my personal opinion, that men have had a lot of chances to do well in leadership positions, maybe it's time to seriously consider a non-male superintendent. Thank you.
Thank you. So again, to those of you that walked in, maybe just recently, there is a green form that is at the front. And if you have that, you will see information from the input of the board already there. But we are inviting you to come and share what may be missing or what you see that is important that we need to ensure that we're covering in the categories of the strengths of our district. If you're identifying that, the greatest needs are desired characteristics. So we are inviting again individuals to come on down, to line up, to please, this is your meeting, to provide input.
Hello to everyone, and thank you for the opportunity for allowing a community input. I think it's very important, being a community advocate and a student advocate and a student from the district from years and years and years ago, and seeing it transform into what it is today. I'm basically here going to address the desired characteristics. Over the years, and I mean years, I've been engaging and coming toward the dais on many issues, from environmental all the way to the African-American achievement and achievement gaps. I just want to make sure that I would like to see our superintendent with the desired characteristics of integrity and being able to address issues specifically targeting African American. I know we're all looking at all inclusive, and I understand that, but when I take a look at a district and the record that we have over the decades, where our numbers for African-American students have not really grown in particular areas, I don't know if you can't tell me that our children can't learn, because I've seen other groups come in and excel in other areas, and our students are still in those same categories. So I don't know if it's, well, it's almost borderline unintentional, in my opinion. So I just want to make sure that the characteristics of an individual, again, is integrity, honesty, and being able to have the trust and be able to gain the trust and relationship from the community as well, and to gather and be open to innovative ideals and approaches on how we can engage and make sure that all our children, because when you talk about, and I always hear, you know, we want all our children, then if that's the case, then why our children are still behind? So I just want to make sure that we are able to have and choose someone that has at least some strong character to be able, if they know that they're making the right decisions, then not to be so easily influenced and swayed and going in another direction when we need going in the right direction. And again, this is from the years of observing and listening to the different people up here and my mentors such as Francis Grice and other people who have came here time and time again, and we're still talking about the same thing that they were talking about. So I just kind of want to see us move to another level. And since we are in the 2020s, and so we just want to be able to catch up. So that's all I have to say. Thank you for the opportunity.
Absolutely, thank you. Dr. Flores, you'd like to, Dr. Flores, for our parents.
solamente quiero invitarlos a venir a dar sus sugerencias. I just said, I would like to invite the Spanish-speaking parents to come up, give us their suggestions as well.
Thank you.
Yes.
Who is going to interpret? Hold one second.
Yeah. So good morning. I'm a mother of a student in the district.
To the mic.
He visto el progreso que ha tenido el distrito con las high schools, middle schools, pero también me gustaría.
I have seen the progress of the district with elementary, middle, and high schools.
Que también se tomaran un poco en cuenta las elementarias, porque también de ahí empieza todo para entrar a middle school y high school.
So we should pay more attention to the elementary schools because that's where the children are prepared for middle school and high school.
Y que pusieran un poquito en que el próximo superintendente viera más sobre los bullying y las cosas que están pasando en el elementaria.
And that the next superintendent would be able to put dedicate attention to the things that are happening in the elementary schools like bullying.
Para poder seguir a middle schools y high schools.
To be able to continue to middle school and high school.
Thank you.
Muy buenos días a todos.
Good morning to everybody.
Gracias por esta invitación y por tomar en cuenta a todos.
Thank you for this invitation and being open to hear from everybody.
Para mí es muy importante lo que es el involucramiento de los padres, que sean realmente involucrados.
For me, it's important the participation, the involvement of parents.
En que no sean nada más considerados como te necesito por una firma y es todo.
Not just that I need you to sign something and that's all.
Porque la verdad hace mucho la diferencia cuando estamos trabajando en equipo como el maestro, el director, el padre y el estudiante.
So it's really important to work as a team, you know, the principal, the teacher, the parents.
Me gustaría que hubiera también una póliza que el nuevo o la nueva superintendente que entre tome muy en cuenta en serio eso. No nada más en los latinos estoy hablando, sino en consideración a todos los estudiantes.
Yeah, I would hope that the next superintendent would be mindful of this, not just working with Latino parents, but with all.
Escuché la preocupación de la señora que también necesitan en los afroamericanos y la entiendo muy bien porque tanto los latinos como los afroamericanos estamos muy bajos.
Yeah, I was listening to the other speaker talking about her concerns with African American students and I understand that, but you know, all students, both Latino and African American students have needs.
Yo lo que quiero es que sea como todos integrados y que todos tenemos la misma oportunidad y todos tenemos las mismas ganas de sobresalir a toda la comunidad.
Yeah, I'd like to see that all students are integrated and involved and all have the same desires for success.
No importa razas, no importa nada, sino que tengan un corazón abierto para toda la comunidad.
Yeah, the race isn't important, but what's important is have an open heart to be able to help the community.
Y que no, yo también quiero agradecer mucho al superintendent.
I am really thankful to the superintendent.
Porque hemos trabajado con él por mucho tiempo.
Because we've worked with him for a lot of time.
Y en verdad sí hizo muchos cambios.
And he has truly made a lot of changes.
Pero no es nada perfecto. Todavía, pero continuar, que esto no caiga, sino que se levante todavía más.
Yeah, it's still not perfect. We don't want it to get worse, but to continue to get better.
Y que sea más accesible con los padres y con la comunidad de abajo.
And that be even more accessible to the parents and to the lower economic community.
Creo que esa es mi opinión para mí. es muy importante.
Yeah, this is my opinion. It's really important.
Y gracias a todos ustedes porque también ustedes han hecho posible que se hagan muchos cambios.
Yeah, and thank you to all of you because you have made it possible for a lot of changes.
Thank you for being there.
Thank you. Thank you.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Antes que nada quiero darles las gracias por atendernos, por escucharnos nuestras preocupaciones.
Okay, above all, I'd like to thank you for being open to hearing to our suggestions and giving us this opportunity.
A mí me gustaría que el nuevo superintendente siguiera apoyando todos los programas que hay para beneficio de los estudiantes.
I would like the new superintendent to be able to support all the programs that are in existence for the good of the students.
También que nos apoyara, yo sé que tenemos apoyo, pero me gustaría un poco más de enfoque para que los niños se reclasifiquen a nivel de primaria.
Yeah, I know that there's a lot of support, but something that's important to me is attention to that the children in the elementary schools would be reclassified.
Para que ya cuando lleguen a la secundaria no tengan esa preocupación y al igual que todos los alumnos lleguen a sacar su diploma.
Yeah, and so that by the time they get to high school they don't have this worry and that all students would be able to, you know, graduate with a diploma.
Y otro sería que fuera, como dice aquí, que fuera amable con todo el personal del distrito, pues igual que fuera amable con todos los miembros de su comunidad, así como era el superintendente.
Okay, that this person would be friendly to all people in the community as a present superintendent.
Eso es todo y gracias por escucharme.
That's all and thank you for listening to me.
Thank you. And I just want to take a quick check-in with the IT. Are we okay with capturing? So again, as you come, they're trying to classify your specific concerns or input in those three areas so they can align them with strengths of the district if you're speaking towards that, critical needs, or the desired characteristics. Welcome.
Empezar dándole las gracias al superintendente anterior.
Yeah, I would like to begin by thanking the present superintendent.
Trabajamos algunas veces con él.
We have worked with him before.
Y en mi opinión, se me hacía una persona tan sencilla que hasta en una ocasión andamos juntando basura en una escuela juntos. De repente volteo y él está a un lado de mí y me quedo, también anda juntando basura como yo.
Yeah, as an example of being able to work with him, I was picking up trash at a school and I turned around and saw him by me and he was also helping to pick up trash.
Eso me dio una buena impresión de él.
This gave me a good impression of him.
Sé que, como alguien mencionaba, nadie es perfecto y todo el trabajo que necesita y requiere este distrito es bastante.
Yeah, as somebody else mentioned, nobody is perfect and this district needs a lot of work.
Y pues, solamente necesitamos encontrar las claves, las estrategias de cómo poder trabajar con toda la diversidad que tenemos.
Yeah, what's important is that we need to figure out what's important and to be able to work with all the stakeholders within the district.
Una de las necesidades que en lo personal trabajando en family engagement, en el involucramiento de padres, bueno, he estado involucro en todos los departamentos, pero he mirado que hay mucha necesidad de información en los padres, para los padres.
Yeah, I've been involved with parent engagement, and something that I've noticed is that it's important to get information to the parents.
Me gustaría que el nuevo superintendente y ustedes mismos, los del board.
Yeah, I would like the new superintendent and you also on the board.
Escuchen más las necesidades de los padres, se involucren más con los padres, escuchen a los padres, porque por medio de estos padres nuestros estudiantes van a alcanzar el éxito académico.
Yeah, that you would listen more to the parents and get involved with the parents, because it's through the parents that our children will be able to be successful.
Nosotros en lo personal, todo este tiempo quisimos trabajar con ustedes, quisimos, los estuvimos invitando a nuestros talleres, a nuestras reuniones. Realmente, pues no vengo a decirles nada negativo, pero no vimos mucha respuesta.
Yeah, we've always been inviting you to participate with us, to come to our workshops, and we haven't had a large response.
Y nos gustaría que escuchen la necesidad, qué programas necesitamos la comunidad, los padres, para nosotros poder fortalecer a nuestros hijos, conocer cómo llevarlos por el camino del éxito.
Yeah, we would like you to know about the needs so that we would be able to strengthen and help our students go forward.
Necesitamos que monitoreen todos los programas, todos los departamentos que estén funcionando en realidad, cada escuela, que todos los programas funcionen, y lo que no funcione o esté maquillado o que funcione, nada más que eran la firma de nosotros, lo vean.
Okay. You know, we need to have you supervising and, you know, monitoring all the programs, departments, and schools, and see that they're truly functioning.
Necesitamos trabajar como equipo. Necesitamos, como decía ahorita una persona afroamericana, hispanos también. Necesitamos algo que sea efectivo, estrategias que unan a las comunidades.
Yeah, we need to be working together, you know, with all groups to be able to, you know, strengthen everything for the good of the students.
America.
Yeah, for African Americans, Hispanics, you know, that doesn't make any difference.
And that we all work together in unity.
Y en unidad. Muchas gracias.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Hola, buenos días.
Good morning.
Mi nombre es Ana Villalbazo. Y quería decirle, en las fortalezas del distrito, me encantan todas las fortalezas que tenemos.
Okay. So I would like to mention about the strengths of the district, and I like all the strengths that are mentioned.
Especialmente en aumentar las graduaciones.
Especially in raising the graduation rate.
Pero quisiera que también nos enfocáramos en aumentar las graduaciones con los requisitos para seguir estudiando.
Yeah, what's important is to be able to raise the graduation rate, but also meeting the requirements to be able to continue studying.
Y en las mayores necesidades en asuntos críticos del distrito.
And the other needs and, you know, the critical issues.
Para mí, en mi opinión, sería la prioridad número uno, el involucramiento de los padres.
The first priority would be parent involvement.
Porque está garantizado.
Because it's guaranteed.
Que cuando un padre se involucra.
When a parent gets involved.
Aumenta el niño académicamente y asistencia.
Okay, that the child does better academically and in attendance.
Y sale listo para la universidad.
And he becomes ready to be able to go to the college.
Y para los atributos del superintendente nuevo.
If the attributes of the new superintendent.
Todo está muy, me encantó muy bien todo lo que pusieron.
Okay, I really like everything that was written down.
Y quisiera... bueno, yo agregué también que sea una persona amable socialmente con los padres.
Okay, that I added that he would be somebody who's nice and gets along with the parents.
Y que sea sencillo poder hablar con él de todas las inquietudes y necesidades que tenemos los padres.
Okay, and that he would be approachable to be able to talk about all the issues and worries, you know, in relationship to the students.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I apologize for working in late. I didn't mean to disturb, but I was working.
I was kind of browsing really quick through the strengths of the district. I agree, but I think overall, for me as a parent and having had an experience and seen experiences, I think the most important thing that we need for improve our district and an attribute for our new superintendent, besides I hoped and wish that it's a female, it's a person that it's bilingual, but it's a person that it's truly human. Human being that he or she understands not only the parents, but most importantly, understands our children. Because our children in this community have a lot of needs, extreme needs that goes beyond food and a roof over their head. I'm referring to psychological help. Mental health, it's an issue that has increasingly been an issue that worries all parents in this community, not only in this community, but in our country. We've seen it, we see it on the news 24/7, how children are being bullied, how children are committing suicide because they're being bullied, either at home, at school, by their own parents, they're being sexually abused. So we need someone that's truly gonna understand and wanna work for our children. Remind that person that he is going to be hired by our children, not by the parents. We, the parents, are the ones that bear the children and educate our children at home. But the most important issue here is that he or she will understand and truly care for the children in our community, because they are the future of tomorrow. They are the future of this community. And as if we walk down the street or we drive down the streets here in San Bernardino, we see how instead of San Bernardino improving, it's declining. We see an increased number of homeless, an increased number of prostitution, you name it, we have it. It is a shame that San Bernardino has become number three city high risk in criminality. It is a shame. When I first moved to San Bernardino back in 2003, I loved it. Now, believe me, I'm ready to pack and leave all this behind, but I can't. Because my children grew up here. My children graduated from this district. So that's my issue. Focus, focus on mental health. That's my issue. We need it. It's important. It's not just, oh yes, we're training counselors. Oh yes, we're working on this. Oh yes, we are. But there is no action. I've said it before. There's a lot of this, but there's no action. And that action speaks louder than words. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next speaker.
Morning.
Can you come a little closer?
Good morning. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Hi, thank you so much for taking the time to listen to all of us. My name is Dominic Zarecki. I'm a data analyst. I work for Fortune School of Education. We operate a teaching administrative credentialing program, but we also operate charter schools, including Hardy Brown College Prep here in San Bernardino. So I wanted to say, I'm a data guy. So what I want to tell you today is very numbers focused, but a strength of the district is actually the college and career indicator. So there are lots of ways we can measure our goals and our success. I think the college and career indicator is a really good one because that's sort of where we hope our students get to by the end of their time with us.
Right.
And San Bernardino City, we're actually green as a district. 40% of our students are ready for either college or career when they graduate. 40% is not super high, but statewide, that's actually right about average. A need is that there's actually a lot of variation across high schools. So unfortunately, at San Andreas High and Sierra High, only 1% of students are prepared for college or career. So that's obviously much lower than the district as a whole. So the desired characteristic for me is not just to sort of focus on where the need is greatest, but also to try to be a learning organization. And that's really hard to do. I wish, my organization is trying to do that as well. But by a learning organization, I mean that whenever possible, we try to make one main effort, one main intervention to reach a particular goal, and we plan in advance how we're going to evaluate the impact of that intervention. Because not everything we try is going to work. And you know, if we just throw the kitchen sink at a problem and nothing happens, we don't know what, or even if something does happen, we don't know, well, what worked and what didn't. And then the next year, we're not really able to, we haven't learned anything about the effectiveness of the efforts we're making. So it's hard to do, but my desired characteristic is, whenever possible, let's try to be disciplined, make one particular effort and plan in advance how we're going to evaluate that. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Are we good? IT, good, we're all good. All right, our next speaker.
Buenos dias a todos.
Good morning to everybody.
Morning.
Gracias por darnos esta oportunidad de escucharnos.
Thank you for this opportunity to, you've given us to listen to
us. Me hizo muy amable de su parte o de quien haya sido la idea de invitar al padre a participar.
Yeah, I really appreciate being invited, that you've invited the parents to participate.
Yo soy madre de 5 hijos.
I'm a mother of 5 children.
Puedo decirles que sea quien trabaje, ha aprovechado mucho lo que el distrito ofrece.
Okay, that they have really benefit from everything the district is offering.
Yo pudiera añadir en las fortalezas del distrito.
I would like to add to the strengths of the district.
Participación del padre.
Parent participation.
Un amplio conocimiento global.
Global knowledge.
Agregar más programas bilingües, no quitar.
Okay, they add more bilingual programs.
Enfoque a los diferentes grupos raciales, académicamente y socialmente.
Focusing on different racial groups academically and socially.
Y conocer bien los beneficios del bilingüismo.
And knowing about the benefits of being bilingual.
Para las mayores necesidades, asuntos críticos del distrito.
For the greatest needs, the critical issues of the district.
Yo pienso en mi poco, lo que yo he podido observar, en mi poco conocimiento.
Okay, according to my limited knowledge and limited being able to observe.
Pienso que es invertir el 100%.
It's to invest 100%.
En programas y capacitación para los educadores.
In programs and professional development of the educators.
Para estudiantes.
For students.
Para un éxito general.
For a general success.
Tanto en programas bilingües como en los no bilingües.
Such as in bilingual programs and programs that aren't bilingual.
Y para los atributos deseados del superintendente, para el nuevo superintendente.
Okay. For the attributes of the new superintendent.
Yo solo puedo reducir a una sola cosa.
I could only reduce the one thing.
Necesitamos en esta comunidad.
We need in this community.
Entre comillas, un líder.
Among, in quotes, a leader.
Que tenga las fortalezas y sabiduría.
It has the strengths and wisdom.
Para guiar este distrito.
To guide this district.
Con tantos retos que tenemos en la actualidad.
With all the challenges that we have at present.
A un éxito en toda su amplitud.
And a success and all that that means.
Y que no solo sea un puesto o un empleo.
And not just being a position, to be fulfilled.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next speaker.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Mi nombre es Gabriela Méndez.
My name is Gabriela Méndez.
Soy una madre de familia.
I am a mother of a family.
Tengo un hijo.
I have a child
quinto grado.
In fifth grade.
Me animé a hablarles.
I wanted to speak with you.
Yo no estoy muy involucrada en esto.
I'm not very involved in this.
Pero ahora mi preocupación es que mi hijo está teniendo dificultades.
Is that my child is having difficulties?
En la escuela.
In school.
Y todavía él no está clasificado.
He is still not classified.
He buscado apoyo.
I have looked for help.
Y no lo he encontrado.
And I haven't found it.
Yo quisiera que el próximo superintendente.
I would like that the next superintendent.
Fuera bilingüe.
Would be bilingual.
Y que en verdad se preocupe.
And that he would truly worry.
Por su comunidad.
About his community.
Que apoye más a las escuelas básicas.
And that he would support the basic schools.
Porque esa es la base.
Because this is the base.
Para que nuestros hijos.
For our children.
Tengan un buen futuro.
Have a good future.
He tenido dificultades para que lo atienda un psicólogo.
I've had problems with a psychologist attending my child.
Tu escuela no tiene mucho apoyo con personal para ayudarlos individualmente.
The school doesn't have the personnel to be able to attend individually to the children.
Motivo por el cual estoy aquí.
And for this reason I'm here.
Para pedirles de favor.
To be able to ask for, please.
Y a los padres que se nos dificulta más tener acceso a ustedes.
That for the parents that have more problems having access to you guys.
Que nos apoye un poco más.
That you would support us a little bit more.
Mi escuela en muy poco tiempo.
My school in just a short amount of time.
Han pasado tres directores.
Has had three different principals.
De los cuales no han durado más de 2-3 meses.
That hasn't been there more for any more than 2 or 3 months.
Y ahí es los que está teniendo un seguimiento los alumnos.
And that the children are being followed up.
Se traspapela y ya no nos hacen caso.
And so we aren't being paid attention to.
Entonces, esa es más que nada mi preocupación.
So this is my worry.
El próximo intendente.
That the next superintendent.
Se preocupe por su comunidad.
That he would worry about his community.
Y más que nada, no tener favoritismo para nadie.
And not have any favoritisms for nobody.
Gracias por escucharme.
Thank you for listening to me.
Thank you.
Madam President?
Yes.
The parent that just left?
Yeah. Para la madre que ya se fue.
Can she make sure we get her name and phone number and get in contact with her? She says she has some issues with one of her children at a school.
Está diciendo si quiere dejar su nombre, número de teléfono, si está teniendo algún problema con una escuela, con su hija.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Buenos días. Mi nombre es Blanca López.
Good morning. My name is Blanca López.
Gracias por permitirnos dar una opinión.
Thank you for giving us this opportunity to give our opinions.
Me gustaría que el nuevo superintendente.
I would like the next superintendent.
Se enfoque en todos los niños elementaria, porque la elementaria es el enfoque al futuro mejor.
Okay, that he would be able to focus on the elementary school because that's, the base for the future.
Ya que los niños van bajo de sus niveles de grado. Eso he estado experimentando yo propiamente con mi hijo.
Okay, that some of the children are below grade level and that's what I'm dealing with my child.
Las respuestas del equipo de la elementaria donde he estado dicen... Tu hijo va bajo, pero no tan bajo. Y por lo tanto, no se le da el apoyo suficiente. Sí, okay. Se le da el apoyo, pero no tan.
Okay, the team at my elementary school says that, yeah, he's a little bit below level, but not that bad. So, you know, we don't give him all the support that he needs. He gets some support.
Me gustaría que este problema es un niño. Y si hay un niño, hay muchos.
So if this is happening with one child, then there's a lot of children, you know, in the same situation.
Me gustaría que se diera el suficiente fondo a cada escuela elementaria, que se le dé para que den el soporte académico a los niños que van medios bajos y bajos, no nada más tan bajos, por favor.
That there would be the resources for in all the schools so that they give the resources to children who are below level, not just those who are far below level.
Pienso que ese es un punto importante donde nuestros niños, todos los niños, no importa la clase, todos llevan un nivel alto.
Yeah, it's important for me that all children would be able to be performing at a high level.
Otra cosa, cuando hacen ustedes eventos.
Another thing when you guys are doing events.
Me gustaría que den más tiempo para las opiniones de los padres.
That you would give more time for parents' opinions.
Ya que he participado en ciertos eventos.
Que I've participated in certain events.
Y van con horario, pero a lo último dicen, oh, dejamos a lo último los comentarios. Y los comentarios es muy corto el tiempo.
Okay, that there's a schedule and then the parent comments are at the end and then there isn't a whole lot of time to hear from the parent comments.
Pienso que es importante un suficiente tiempo para todos nosotros los padres, porque si trabajamos juntos, tenemos mejores soluciones.
Yeah, we need to give time for parents' comments because if we work together, then things will just be better.
Otro punto. En las high school, me gustaría que dieran un soporte que todos los estudiantes.
Okay, another thing is that in the high schools that there would be support for all students.
Vayan a camino a un diploma, no un certificado, por favor.
Okay, that all the students would be able to get a high school diploma, just not a certificate.
Porque queremos un San Bernardino mejor.
Because we want a better San Bernardino.
De unos gentes profesionales.
To have more professionals.
Estoy cansada de escuchar que San Bernardino es distrito malo. No, tenemos que cambiar. Estamos 2020 y es tiempo de cambiar, por favor.
Yeah, I'm tired of hearing about San Bernardino not being a very good school district. It's time for a change.
Eso es todo. Y me da gracias por la participación de Ms. Wen and Dr. Hills de la que hicieron el meeting el sábado. Me agrada de parte de ustedes del board porque anteriormente se hacían intocables.
Okay. I think for the participation of some of the board members in the meeting we had on Saturday, Mrs. Gwynn and Mrs. Hill.
Donde escucha a la comunidad. Lo malo es que no hay suficiente participación de nosotros, la comunidad, porque igual no hay suficiente invitación, pienso.
Okay.
Y tiene que haber traductor.
Uh-huh. So, it's there's not always a whole lot of participation from the community. There's not always a lot of opportunity and we need to have translators.
Pero me gusta, y el nuevo superintendente es una persona que nos representa, pero también son parte ustedes del board.
So the new superintendent, somebody who represents us, but is also a part of you guys, the board.
Y el board está trabajando en equipo junto con el superintendente. Vamos a hacer la máxima potencia en San Bernardino.
So if the board and the superintendent work together, that would be the best thing for San Bernardino.
Eso es mi punto a decir.
So this is what I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, board. Good morning, community. My name is Fatima, and while I work with the California Charter Schools Association, I also choose to live in San Bernardino, and I'm very proud to do so. But I also wanted to let you know that every month, San Bernardino charter school leaders get together to share best practices, and today is supposed to be our meeting, and we all committed to being here. So all my charter school leaders in the room, can you just raise your hand? So I want you to know that we're all here because we really wanted to hear all the input that the community has for a superintendent and that you have for us as well. And so as far as strengths, we agree. I think communication and collaboration has always been a strength of the superintendent and the district, and we'd like to see that continued. Greatest need is having someone with a holistic approach to education that also includes the many and various factors that affect our child's education, because as we know, it's not just getting them in the classroom, is getting them safely on the way to school, what's going on at home, and so having a holistic approach to the education that students receive in the classroom. And desired characteristics, I don't think I'm alone in saying this. I want a Superman or a Wonder Woman. I think that's what our kids deserve. And so short of a superhero, I'd like someone who's student-focused and centered, fair to families choosing our local charters, and adaptable to the changing times. Thank you.
Thank you.
Morning, Board President Dottie Rogers, board members, and Deputy Superintendent Volkmer. I'm Alex Cicero, I'm the CEO of Real Journey Academies, and we currently operate Entrepreneur High School, iEmpire, and our first charter school, New Vision Middle School. 11 years of being part of San Bernardino City Unified School District family, I have come to deeply value and cherish the leadership of the board and staff. We would appreciate to have the next superintendent value school choice and include charter schools as part of all activities. We want to see a leader who unifies and shapes San Bernardino into the forefront of education and workforce. We have the ability and talent to be exceptional, not only in the Inland Empire, nationwide, and world. Talent is here. We need a leader who unifies and supports the African-American communities and Latino communities, bring out the best to drive them towards success. San Bernardino is my home, and I want the next superintendent to understand this isn't a job, but this is part of life. Thank you, and on a side note, I want to say this is an amazing improvement you guys done. Very beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Yo estuve buscando al superintendente mucho tiempo, más de dos meses.
Yeah, I've been looking for the superintendent for more than 2 months.
Nunca lo conocí.
I never met him.
Mi hijo estaba sufriendo de bullying por la maestra.
My child was suffering from bullying by the teacher.
Y nadie creía, querían que lo cambiara de escuela, que lo cambiara de salón. Nadie le creía al niño.
Okay, nobody believed the child wanted to change them, you know, classroom or school.
La psicóloga nunca lo atendió.
The psychologist never attended him.
Tuve que conseguir otra psicóloga por fuera.
I had to get another psychologist outside of the district.
Este, necesitamos otro superintendente que atienda a uno cuando más lo necesite.
We need a superintendent who is able to help somebody when they really need it.
La maestra ya creo que ya no está.
The teacher is no longer there.
Ah, pusieron otra maestra, un sustituto.
There's another teacher, a substitute.
Pero el daño ya está hecho.
The damage is already done.
No sé qué va a pasar con mi hijo. Si
I don't know what's going to happen to my child.
Todo lo que
that's all I wanted to say.
I just wanted to ask that has he reached out to the district and we can take his information again and ensure that, but you might want to translate.
Señor, quiero decirle que es muy importante todos los niños y que disculpe, pero tenemos que atender a tu hijo. Y por favor, dale su nombre, la escuela y todo. Carlos, raise your hand. Carla, por favor. Gracias. I just said that in our district, we as board members and staff want to deal with every student fairly and support them, and just ask him to go and give her his name, and we'll follow through. Is that correct, Dr. Volkmer? Yes.
Thank you for that. Our next speaker.
Good morning. My name is Maribel Soto. I'm a parent of two children. One goes to Hillside. The other one goes to SOAR Charter Academy. My Hillside was a problem because he was enrolled in North Park last year. This new school year, I get a phone call that he was capped out. So when I called the school district, the enrollment center, they threw me to the capping program. From the capping program, they threw me to the youth services. I took 2 days off work to try and deal to get a better answer. This was, I believe, a Thursday. I wanted to speak to Ms. Downing, which is the North Park Elementary School teacher, principal. She was my school teacher. I did go to elementary, junior high in San Gorgonio, but she never called me back. I wanted to speak to the youth services director. Never got a phone call back. Wanted to speak to superintendent. I understand he's busy in meetings. Didn't get a phone call back. Capping program, when we finally told my son that he was going to have to go to another school because of a capping program, the capping program person said that I would get a phone call from a psychologist because he did get depressed for a couple weeks. Dad and I watched him, of course. And nobody called me, not a psychology, not a phone call from anybody to follow up. North Park did call me back about a month ago and offered to transfer my son again. I said no, because transferring kids from school to school, it does harm them one way or the other, going into a different school. I do not believe in switching kids from one school to another school. So just take responsibility, either capping, youth services, the school district, enrollment, I don't know. Take responsibility, prepare it, the parent and the kid, or you know, the student, that you are going to be capped out. Don't throw them in and then kick them out. The day that we took him on Monday afternoon, I get home and he shows me a bus pass. So basically he was pretty much thrown in with no directions. Nobody called me from North Park to say, okay, this is the last day. We've accommodated him at Hillside. So that's when I took another day off from work to find out if this was true, because he was just sent home with a bus pass. I don't need the bus transportation. Thank goodness my husband is home and he can be the ride. Okay, so I just really want responsibility from enrollment, youth services, the capping program, and better organization.
And that would fall, in, I think, into our critical needs, correct? That's where you're speaking. Oh, okay, yes. Thank you. And then your last phone calls, have you been in contact with the district at all? So we'd ask you also, even though we're not shifting the meeting, but we definitely want you to give your information so that we can follow up, and we appreciate that.
Of course. Thank you.
Thank you.
Madam President?
Yes.
I just want to say to you and everyone, you know, the board is part of the process also, and we hate to hear when parents contact the district and you don't hear back from us. But, you know, as you're going up the chain, after you call the superintendent, it'd be great to find one of our numbers and call us. I mean,
that's our role also. I took the time to write out a letter to the school district, and I forwarded it to the capping program in North Park. I'm sure it's out there somewhere, but nobody's responded to it.
Yeah, and I'm just taking the opportunity to tell everyone.
You can CC us on that.
Yeah, when you get in the situation, please feel free to reach out and call one of us or call me. I would love the opportunity to help solve the problem.
Thank you.
Ditto, I agree. Fani, are you're coming? Fani.
I'm sorry again, but solamente quiero decirles, una de las cosas que tengo que admirar ahorita del superintendente, lo que empezó a hacer con los niños especiales.
Yeah, one thing that I would like to tell you that I admire about the superintendent is something's done with special needs children.
Porque por muchos años no se hacían cambios de pólizas. Yo sé que han habido controversias, pero es bueno porque quiere decir de que van a hacer poco a poco cambios porque estaban olvidados.
Okay, that for a long time there hasn't been change of policies, but little by little things are changing.
Y creo que eso es muy importante mencionar también, de que también los niños especiales necesitan de ser parte de la comunidad.
Yeah, something that's important is that the special need children need to be a part of the community.
Y lo que quiero ver también con este superintendente es que quiera unir a todos los programas, a todos los ¿cómo se llama? Porque yo sé que no queremos ver competencia. Quiero ver que se haga unidad, que todos traemos algo para enseñar.
Yeah, that there needs to be more unity, that we're all here for the same thing.
Y por los programas que tenemos, que hay durante todo el distrito, yo sé que hay muchos, pero hay veces de que hay mucha controversia cuando hay desunidad, y eso se tiene que ver unidad.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I know there's a lot of programs that sometimes look like there's disunity. What we really need is unity.
Tanto en los programas como en los centros de padres, con las organizaciones, con yeah. Todo, porque todos traemos ideas diferentes.
Yeah, so they could be if it's programs, or parent centers, or organizations. What we need is unity.
Para mí es muy muy impactado eso, y aparte de eso, otra cosa que he mirado un poco. Ustedes trabajan muy bien y gracias por la oportunidad con la comunidad.
So you guys do a good job and the community is grateful.
Pero hay algo en de que yo he notado que a veces uno a otro no saben todas las mismas cosas que están pasando.
So something I've noticed that not all of you know the same things that are, you know, are aware of the same things that are happening.
Como que no hay mucha comunicación y tampoco con el superintendente, y creo que eso va a impactar mucho también.
Okay, that there might be a lack of communication and communication with the superintendent.
Y en verdad estamos aquí dispuestos para trabajar, seguir trabajando.
Yeah, and we're here to willing to work.
Y ahora voy a hablar como empleada.
And now I'm going to speak as an employee.
Creo que yo siento que como Recase no tenemos el valor y no nos han como que ay, eres Recase y eres como que a un lado.
Okay, sometimes I feel like that us as Recase don't have the same value as others.
Entonces me gustaría que sí se monitoreara por esa parte.
So, I would ask that this would be supervised, monitored.
Porque hay muchos privilegios en el cual no es igualdad.
So that the privileges and stuff, there's an equality for everybody.
Ah, y otra cosa que se me está olvidando. Mucha comunicación con los consejeros.
Yeah, something I was forgetting is communication with the counselors.
Porque los consejeros son parte muy importante para la educación de los hijos cuando están en high school.
Yeah, the counselors are really important for the children when they're in high school.
Que la mayor parte de los consejeros solo los quieren mandar a colegios comunitarios.
That the majority of the counselors want to send the students to community colleges.
No digo que es malo, pero si tienen el potencial de ir a una universidad, ellos pueden ir.
So that isn't necessarily bad, but if the student has the potential of going to a university, that's, better.
Y también se me hizo buena idea lo que tiene el superintendente con los pathways.
So what I like about the superintendent, is his ideas about the pathways.
pero siento que no todos los niños tienen la oportunidad de entrar. Es muy poco, ojalá y se pudiera incrementar para que todos los niños tengan esa oportunidad.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like all the students have the opportunity to get into a pathway. It'd be better if all the students had that opportunity.
Creo que son mis puntos más fuertes que necesito, porque lo he escuchado de padres, y ustedes como me conocen, que trabajo en la comunidad, siento que yo ahorita soy la voz de ellos.
So I feel like I'm the voice of the parents. Not all the parents have the opportunity to be able to express the same thing.
Muchas gracias por todo lo que han hecho, y entiendo su posición, no es fácil.
Yeah, thank you for everything. I understand your position. It isn't easy.
Pero por algo Dios los tiene allí.
Yeah, for that reason, God has you there.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Mi nombre es María Solana y soy una madre de familia.
My name is María Solana and I am a mother of three children.
Fortalezas del distrito. A mí me gustaría que sigan apoyando a los estudiantes a que no nomás agarren el diploma de high school, sino que sigan agarrando sus clases de la A a la G para que sean algo más del futuro.
So something that's important to me is in supporting high school students that they just not get their diploma, but they would be taking the A through G classes.
Para que sigan en la universidad.
Yeah, so they'd be able to continue to the university.
Y que lo sigan, pues, más motivando para que ellos sigan estudiando.
So that they would be motivated to be able to continue studying.
Otra de las mayores necesidades, estamos viendo que nos gustaría también que se apoyen más a los subdirectores.
Okay, another need is that there be more support for the vice principals.
Y que cada escuela tenga un subdirector.
And that each school would have a vice principal.
Y también que no nomás sea, llega un director y le ofrecen un trabajo con más paga.
Not just that a principal arrives and they offer him another job with more pay.
Ya nomás dice, me voy y dejo la escuela y los niños abandonados.
And he says, well, I'm going, and he leaves this, abandons the school, abandons the children.
Hay muchas escuelas que se quedan bastante tiempo sin director.
There are a lot of schools that that happens that they don't have a principal for a long time.
Una de nuestras escuelas se quedó bastante tiempo sin director.
One of the schools that didn't have a principal for a long time.
Y desafortunadamente tampoco no tenemos su director.
And we don't have a vice principal.
Entonces a mí me gustaría que se tomara en cuenta que todas las escuelas tengan, que no se queden tanto tiempo sin director.
That the school wouldn't be last a long time without having a principal.
Porque de ahí comienza a que los niños, sabiendo que no hay un director,
and that the children, knowing that there isn't a principal,
pueden hacer lo que ellos quieran, o
that they could do whatever they want to do.
Entonces, siempre tiene que estar la base.
So there always needs to be there that base.
Para que los niños sean también buenos estudiantes y buen futuro para la comunidad.
So that the children would be good students and have a good future.
Atributos deseados el de superintendente, a mí me gustaría que fuera una persona bilingüe.
Okay, as far as attributes for the new superintendent, I would like him to be bilingual.
Ya que vemos bastante, un porcentaje grande de hispanos, entonces para podernos comunicar con él.
So that since we have such a large Hispanic community that we'd be able to communicate with him.
También me gustaría que se le diera oportunidad también a una mujer.
And that it would also be to give the opportunity to a lady.
Porque pues también tanto como hombres y mujeres somos igualdad y también tienen las mismas opiniones también que los hombres. También puede trabajar igual.
Okay, so women and men are able to work equally and have the same opinions and stuff.
Es todo y muchas gracias.
That's all, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah. Quiere hacerle una pregunta.
What school was it that didn't have a principal?
¿Cuál escuela fue que no tenía un director?
Ah, Belvedere. Se quedó por bastante tiempo sin director.
Thank you.
Next speaker.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Mi nombre es Roxana Cervantes.
My name is Roxana Cervantes.
Madre de dos estudiantes del distrito, segundo y sexto grado.
I have two children in the district, second and sixth grade.
Y comprendo que no es fácil estar al frente del distrito escolar más grande del condado.
Yeah, I understand it isn't easy to be the head of the largest school district in the county.
Pero estoy segura que trabajando en equipo, todos unidos, podemos.
Yeah, I believe that working as a team together, everything is possible.
Primero, permítanme felicitarlos.
First, let me congratulate you.
Por las nuevas instalaciones.
For the new facilities.
Por las nuevas posiciones.
For the new positions.
Por el trabajo en equipo.
For
que
the
se
teamwork.
Ve que hacen.
We could see that you do.
Y quiero empezar con las fortalezas.
And I would like to begin with the strengths.
Veo fortalezas reales.
I see real strengths.
Pero agregaría.
But I would add.
En el punto de la diversidad.
In the point of diversity.
Unir esta diversidad.
To unite this diversity.
Nuestro distrito necesita trabajar juntos.
Our district needs to work together.
Como comunidad.
As a community.
No importa la cultura, el origen, las preferencias, etc.
Yeah, it isn't important the origin or the differences of opinions. That isn't important.
Considerar a todos los grados escolares.
They consider all school grades.
Como ya lo comentaron algunos participantes.
As some participants have already expressed.
Y como el título de distrito escolar significa.
And what the title of a school district means.
Con el título de distrito unificado.
The unified district.
No quiero dejar pasar la oportunidad de que sí se necesita.
I don't want to let the opportunity pass that we do need.
Dar seguimiento a las situaciones que se presentan.
To follow up on the situations that are presented.
Me identifico con varios padres que aquí han hablado.
I identify with various parents who have spoken here.
Necesitamos trabajo en las escuelas.
We need work in the schools.
Necesitamos participación de padres.
We need parent participation.
Y no solamente participación.
Not just participation.
Verdadero compromiso.
A true commitment.
Necesitamos que el enfoque no sea solo académico.
That the focus isn't just academic.
¿Dónde queda el apoyo emocional, social, cultural y moral de nuestros estudiantes?
Okay, we need moral and social and cultural support.
Como madre me preocupa.
As a parent, I worry.
No solamente quiero una buena nota.
I just don't want good grades.
Quiero un hijo sano en todos los sentidos.
I want a healthy child and with all that that means.
Me importa la vía alfabetización.
Literacy is important.
O de ser posible la multi-alfabetización.
Or literacy.
Característica principal de las potencias mundiales.
Which is important characteristic in the world.
No es importante solamente hablar otro idioma.
It isn't just important to speak one other language.
Se necesita aprender a leerlo, a escribirlo y a comprenderlo también.
Okay, to be able to write and understand and read another language.
I work on that.
I'm working on that.
En la participación de padres.
In the parent participation.
Se necesita fortalecer la confianza.
We need to strengthen the trust.
El respeto y la unidad.
The respect and unity.
Mejorar la comunicación.
Better communication.
Que sea efectiva y positiva.
That the communication be effective and positive.
Erradicar el favoritismo.
To root out favoritism.
La intimidación.
The intimidation.
Y las represalias.
And reprisals.
De verdad lo vivimos.
We truly live that.
Aquí no importan las relaciones personales.
That the personal relationship shouldn't be important.
Aquí importa ser profesional.
What is important is to be professional.
Como atributos para un superintendente.
For attributes for a superintendent.
Yo remarcaría.
I would emphasize.
La ética no solamente laboral, también social.
Okay, not just work ethic, but social ethic.
Que sea accesible.
That we would be accessible.
Y que esté dispuesto a trabajar en equipo.
That we would be willing to work as a team.
Con escuelas.
With schools.
Estudiantes.
Students.
Y familias.
And families.
Todos tenemos altas capacidades.
We all have a lot of abilities.
Lo difícil es encontrar la motivación.
What's hard is to find the motivation.
Y las oportunidades.
And the opportunities.
Gracias nuevamente por este espacio.
Thanks once again for this opportunity.
Thank you.
Yes, mi nombre es Monica Bulight. Tengo un estudiante en la cajón, es un senior.
Okay, good morning. My name is Monica Blight, and I have a student, a child at Cajon.
Yo quiero hablar de las fortalezas. Una de las cosas que me gustaría ver sería más clases vocacionales para los niños.
Okay, I would like to talk about the strengths. One of the things I would like to see is there be more vocational classes.
Y hablarle a los niños de que también pueden ir a tomar esas clases o esos cursos si ellos quieren, porque muchos niños se estresan pensando que la única opción es colegio o universidad.
Okay, and that they can take these vocational classes. A lot of students think that the only path is to go to college or university.
Y se estresan mucho. Eso sería bueno que tuvieran eso en las high schools y desde las middle schools también.
Okay, sometimes the students get stressed out about that, and it would be good to have these opportunities in the high schools and middle schools.
En las mayores necesidades, yo creo que necesitan ayudar más a los niños que están padeciendo de bullying.
Okay, as far as needs, we need to be able to support those students who are being bullied.
Sigue existiendo mucho bullying en las escuelas desde elementarias, middle schools y high schools.
Okay, that there is a lot of bullying in the schools, elementary, middle and high schools.
Y hay en ocasiones que los maestros o los principales no ponen atención a los niños, no ponen atención a los padres cuando estos se quejan.
Okay, and that the teachers or principals don't pay attention to these things when they're happening.
Por favor, pongan atención a esto. Mi niño tuvo una experiencia en la middle school. Gracias a Dios me ayudaron mucho, pero sé de otros casos donde no los ayudan.
Yeah, my child had such an experience in the middle school. I did get a lot of support, but I know that not all children get that support.
Sobre el intendente, me gusta, superintendente, como la elección, me gustaría que fuera una elección clara y con los de la manera que tiene que ser, que no sea apuntado, que no sea porque cierta persona lo eligió, sino que sea un proceso como debe de ser.
That in choosing the next superintendent, that it would be a process, that how it should be, that taking it, a lot of things into consideration.
Que no sea apuntado nada más, que no sea porque alguien lo escogió y sea el que va a ser, sino que sea el proceso legal como debe de ser.
Okay, that they would follow a legal process, just not somebody choosing him.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next speaker.
Hi, my name is Joette Spencer Campbell, and
I wasn't going to say anything, but I thought that perhaps I should. I look at all the things that you have on here, and I think these are all great. And I'm sure you had one the last time. And I didn't have much interaction. I didn't have much interaction with Superintendent Marsden, but from what I did see, I saw some changes and they were positive. I'm very hopeful for this process now, what we're going through, and I just think it's a hopeful time for San Bernardino. But I've been hopeful before. I have 3 children that I raised through San Bernardino City Schools. I have 7 grandchildren. 4 of them are now in the district. One of them is at Mahone High School. She has a 4.1. She's doing very well. And she did transition from charter schools. The last time I was really hopeful and positive about the direction that the school district was going, and I have heard, because I do still know people in the district, I have heard a lot of good things that Dr. Marsden did. And I really believe that right now we're on the threshold of really being able to make a change. I hear the negative things, you know, we're the 3rd worst city to live in the country. And because of that, this is a good time. We have no place to go but up. And I believe that for the parents in the community, that the selection that you make is not only about education, it's about survival. And our children, we've been, I'm not saying whether we need an African-American, a Latino, or any of that. What I'm saying is that we do know how to take care of other people's children, though. With the NAACP, we've been inclusive. A lot of the things that are happening now for people in this country are based on things that African-Americans did. And I see some of the things that are happening now, those things began in 2005. We were the only district that had a policy that addressed the low achievement of not only African-American students, then the Latino students, and all of the other performance groups. I've seen they've taken that out to the county. Even when you talk about the African-American district advisory groups, now you hear that not only in San Bernardino, throughout the county. So the things that we did starting in 2004, 2005, when we started to desegregate that data, those things are now happening all around this county. So whatever we do now as we go forward, those things are going to make a difference, not only for San Bernardino, and I really believe it's going to make a difference. Whoever you select, I think it's going to be the best selection. Because I believe that the hearts, I've seen the hearts and the movements of the board members. I know you're going to make the best decision based on what our community needs. And I believe that the parents are an important group. I do see, just like right now, how many parents are actually here representing the lowest performing group, though? So that's, although it's listed on this paper, when we talk about all, how many of those parents are in this room right now? There's a reason for that, why they're not here. So that's one thing when we list it as a critical need, and when we say all students and all of the parents here that have come up and spoke, they've talked about the parents being the most important group. I think one of the things when you go back and you meet, why weren't the parents of the lowest performing group here? And I think that that should be at the top of the list when you are looking for someone, that I think that we can do it. And I just appreciate you having this meeting and allowing us to voice our opinions.
Thank you. And it looks like we're getting close to our final speaker. I want to remind everyone, we do have an evening program again at 5:30. And even if you can't make that meeting, it is also, you can go to the website and log your information there. So we want to make sure we're right at 2 hours now. And as we're attempting to wrap it up, remember there is another opportunity tonight, and you can also go on the website. All right, next speaker.
We didn't name it. My name is Dixie Carlson, last name is spelled with a K. I and my husband are retired teachers from San Bernardino. Our daughter is a retired teacher from San Bernardino. Our granddaughter is a substitute teacher in San Bernardino. And I have great grandchildren in the district.
So wow.
I think you can say I have a vested interest in our district. And I have heard lots of concerns, but I want people to understand that this district really does try to help the people that have concerns. I have come to the school with some concerns that I had and didn't get them solved, so I went higher and higher and higher until I came down here. And I have seen meetings held because of my concerns, school meetings, which lets me know that you as a board and as staff here on hand really do care about what happens at your schools. I did want to mention that as a strength is that if you go high enough, something does get done. And you just need to, like you have said, Mr. Tillman, higher and higher until you come to us, if that's what needs to be. But I did have a couple of, I did want to mention that I have a couple of concerns. One, well, I want you to know I still volunteer in the schools. I'm involved with the schools. I feel they have some rules and regulations with their family engagement, family problem, family involvement, that makes it hard for these parents with young children to participate at the school level. And I think I think we have to look at that very closely, because that's a very big concern of mine. We keep saying that families are important, but if they're important, then we have to make it available for them to be involved, okay? Also, after listening this morning, I think it's very important that we set up a panel, not necessarily a committee, because committees don't always get things done, but a panel that will listen to all of the local concerns. And parents need to be made aware of the fact that that panel is there. These people that are coming with concerns here, they should have been heard at some other level to begin with. And so that is a concern I have. And as far as qualifications for the new superintendent, I think Superintendent Marston has done a good job. He's done some very good things. But I am concerned that I don't want us to look so far outside. We have some very good staff members within our own area, our own staff right here, that should be concerned for that position, considered for that position. And I want to thank you for listening and keep doing the job that you're doing. Thank you.
Excuse me, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Go ahead.
You said that there are some rules associated with the parent engagement.
Yes.
That work against parents any parents involved, but you didn't say what they are. What are they?
Well, the one that I'm very aware of is that they make it very hard for you to come to the school if you have a young child, because you can't bring the young child with you.
Well, the rule is you can't bring the young child with you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's a volunteer.
So, and when I looked into it, they said it was because of insurance concerns. But I should think that the board or could write some kind of a regulation that allows a parent to sign off that if something happens to the child while they're at school, they will not sue the school district. There has to be some way you can overcome that block. Because these young mothers can't bring a young child with them, they're out. So
I'm glad I asked you, because I know at some of the events, they actually provide child care. So I know there's a way around it. So,
well, but they don't at all the schools.
Exactly. So I'm glad to hear that. Thank you very much.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
And I wanted to comment. You saw me going and talking to some of the board members. In fact, I commented that just having a regular community forum for us just to listen to parents in our community be a really great idea for us to do, because when we have meetings, they just go long, 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 and you get
right.
You have a limitation. So I mean, I would like to propose that we consider something. I don't know how often, but that we would have community forums like this so
right.
that we
okay.
get input from the community. And that's all we do.
Okay.
We listen and maybe respond, but listen.
But if you do that, you have to make it the parents aware that it's available.
Yes,
to.
Yes.
Communication
yes.
is very, very important.
Yes,
there.
Yes, I know.
Okay.
That's what I'm talking about, allowing
okay.
parents to participate, also community members in a forum right. that we hold on a regular basis.
So keep in mind, we are gathering this information because that probably falls into, a critical need.
Yes.
So we're logging this, board members. Remember, we're going to have our meeting after this. Thank
okay.
you so
Thank
much.
You.
Next speaker.
Okay, I already spoke earlier, and I'm wondering if all of the comments that were made today are going to be printed up, because I was here at the beginning, and I think we've had about 35 speakers up there, but we only have 16 or 17. They'll all be there on the website?
Go ahead, Dr.
If I can address that. These are two running lists. These are not the same list. So
okay.
actually, it reflects 31, if I'm looking how long that. So it does reflect the comments of all the speakers.
Thank you.
It's
That's
two
good.
Different lists.
Okay. And one of the things I was listening to people talk about, their communities not being represented. And I thought this might be a time to talk about greatest needs, critical issues for the district would be to give accurate history regarding Native Americans. I'm an enrolled member of Cheyenne River Sioux Tribe in South Dakota, and we have a really good Indian program in San Bernardino, but I'm not sure that everyone knows about it. But we have very good results graduation-wise and otherwise with the students that are participating in it. But our kids are sitting there in classrooms going, well, that's not true according to my grandparents, my parents. And I know a lot of research has been done in that area, and I'm wondering if they can eventually fix that or come up with alternative lessons, even in California history. So that might be a good time to address that since we're going through all these changes. That's all.
All right. Thank you. And I just want to remind us as board members, because we're getting some great information. This information is... We're so grateful with the IT because, you know, we're writing notes as well, but they're capturing it all. We're going to have this so that we can make some decisions. But again, we just want to make sure we get the input. So, Dr. Flores, did you have a...
My comment that it's all right. We are inclusive as a board. And in fact, we want to propose ethnic studies so that we include... the roots and history of all our groups.
Next speaker.
Buenos días.
Good
Mi nombre
morning.
Es Rebeca Castro.
My name is Rebeca Castro.
Estoy en el distrito aquí desde hace 14 años.
I've been in the district for 14 years.
Tengo 5 hijos.
I have 5 children.
Por primera vez que llegué a este distrito,
when I first came to this district,
llegué por el bullying de un niño que tenía 8 años, uno de mis hijos que tenía 8 años.
Yeah, I came here because one of my children, 8 years old, was being bullied.
Desde hace ese tiempo me involucré en el distrito.
Since that time I've been involved in the district.
Y sí he mirado grandes cambios que hizo el director anterior.
Yeah, I have seen a lot of changes that the former superintendent has done.
El superintendente Marsden.
Superintendent Marsden.
No sé por qué se fue.
I don't know why he's left.
Creo que los padres no nos dieron un detalle, una explicación. No sé, algo no está claro aquí.
Yeah, so that hasn't been explained to the
no
parents.
No sé si fue su tiempo, pero igual, Va a venir un nuevo director y me gustaría que siga mejorando nuestras escuelas.
Yeah, so we'll be getting a new director and I'm hoping that our schools will be improving.
Sé que el asiento que todos ustedes están ocupando no es para siempre.
I know that the seats that you guys are in isn't forever.
Pero también sé que el mejoramiento que ustedes dan nos deja un buen recuerdo a todos los padres.
Yeah, I just know that the environment that you guys are in gives us a good memory for all the parents.
Yo pido como padre.
I ask as a parent.
No están mis hijos, pero también pido como estudiantes.
My children aren't here, but I also ask as a student.
Que venga un director capacitado.
That a director would come who is has ability.
Y de preferencia que sea bilingüe.
And as a preference that he would be bilingual.
Para poder comunicarnos directamente como padres con él.
So that he would be able to communicate directly to us as parents.
Sé que hay intérpretes.
I know that there are interpreters.
Pero cuando hablamos directamente con el corazón y nos entendemos en el idioma.
But when we speak from our heart and we are understood in our own language.
Sentimos que ellos también sienten nuestro dolor de padre.
We are aware that they also feel our pain as a parent.
Y podemos comunicarnos mejor.
And that we could be able to communicate better.
A mí me gustaría que hubieran tomado en cuenta también a los jóvenes para para agarrar un mejor director, escuchar sus sugerencias de ellos también.
Okay, I would, that also that you would consider the opinion, listen to our youth in choosing the next superintendent.
Ya que mis hijos, uno va en el colegio, otro va en la universidad, otro va a terminar su grado 12 y yo les pregunto, ¿cómo les gustaría un director?
Yeah, I have a child in the university and college and in the 12th grade. I asked them, how would you like our new superintendent to be?
Y ellos me comentan sus necesidades.
And they comment to me on their needs.
Y me gustaría que también los escucharan a ellos, porque ellos son los de el salón en la escuela.
Okay, I would like you to listen to also to them because they are in the classroom.
Yo soy su madre y vengo aquí a hablar por ellos.
I am their mother and I come here to speak for them.
Pero ellos son los que tratan a los maestros.
But they're the ones that deal with the teachers.
A los consejeros.
With the counselors.
A los que trabajan adentro en la escuela.
Those who work in the school.
Ellos también tienen la opinión de decir, me gusta este cambio.
They also have their opinions and say, I would like this, change.
También ellos sufren ahí adentro en las escuelas y muchas veces nosotros no estamos en la escuela. Estamos alrededor de la escuela.
Yeah, and they suffer in school. We aren't in the schools. We're just around them.
Y como padres.
And as parents.
Muchas veces queremos ver puras A's en sus grados.
Yeah, we just like to see all A's in their grades.
Pero no sabemos lo que ellos luchan adentro.
But we don't know about their battles, inside.
Para sacar buenas calificaciones.
But to be able to get those good grades.
Yo pido un buen director.
I ask for a good superintendent.
Que tenga valores.
That has values.
Que no nada más quiera agarrar un alto número en su cheque.
That just doesn't want a high check.
Que demuestre sus habilidades.
That shows his abilities.
Escuche tanto al niño, al adolescente como al joven.
That he would listen to, children and youth.
Creo que unidos podemos hacer un cambio total.
Together we can make a complete change.
San Bernardino lo ocupa.
San Bernardino needs it.
Nuestros hijos lo ocupan.
Our children need a change.
Nosotros como padres también estamos aquí para ayudar, porque también nosotros como padres ocupamos ser escuchados.
Yeah, as parents, we're here to help, and as parents, we need to be listened to.
Y como dijo la señorita que estudia.
As the lady who said that studies.
No necesitamos un director que sea puesto por una conveniencia.
We just don't want a superintendent who is put there just for convenience.
Necesitamos un director que sea por igual a todos.
We need a superintendent who's equal to everybody.
Necesitamos buenos maestros en los salones.
We need good teachers in the classrooms.
Necesitamos buenos consejeros.
We need good counselors
en las oficinas.
In the offices.
Necesitamos que nuestros hijos sean puestos en las clases que deben de agarrar para ir a la universidad.
You know, we need our children to be in the right classes to be able to go to college.
Necesitamos que les den el SAT, todos los programas que necesitan para ir a una universidad.
We need for our children to be able to receive everything they need to be able to go to college.
Yo voy a contar algo cuando mi hijo quería ir a la universidad.
Yeah, when my child wanted to go to the university.
La consejera le dijo que él no podía ir porque no tenía dinero.
The counselor said that he couldn't go because he didn't have money.
Como gracias a Dios, yo he venido aquí precisamente por ese niño de 8 años que su ilusión era ir a la universidad.
Yeah, for this reason I have come, you know, for this child who wants to go to the college.
Yo sabía que sí hay mucho dinero para todo niño que quiera estudiar.
Yeah, I know that there's lots of money for those children who want to study.
Y yo le dije a ella, tú solamente ocúpate, por favor, de darle a mi hijo lo que necesita. Yo sé que sí hay dinero para él.
Yeah, I told him just to worry about giving my child what he needs. I know that there's money available for him.
Yo sé que ella hizo cosas para que mi hijo no pudiera ir a la universidad.
I know that she did things so that my child wouldn't be able to go to college.
Pero sé que nosotros como padres somos guerrilleros.
But us as parents, we're warriors.
Mi hijo lleva 2 años de universidad.
My child has been going to college for 2 years.
Preparen a los consejeros que abran la puerta. No aumenta el número de jóvenes para ir a la universidad. ¿Por qué?
Yeah, we should prepare the counselors to open the doors so that students are able to go to college.
Porque hay muchos consejeros que no los quieren ayudar.
Because there's lots of counselors that don't want to help them.
Traigan un director que sea por igual y que se preocupe porque tanto estudiante, consejero, maestro, trabajador, vayamos en el mismo camino.
Yeah, we need a superintendent who is able to unify, you know, the counselors, teachers, you know, students, everybody to go on the same road.
Ahora aquí no solamente es la educación.
It isn't just education.
San Bernardino está sufriendo por otras cosas más.
Okay, San Bernardino is suffering because of other things.
Nuestros niños están sufriendo de bullying.
Our children are suffering because of bullying.
Acosados para que usen drogas.
Harassed so that they would use drugs.
And so we appreciate your comments. We certainly thank you for that. We can also reach out to you as well.
Okay. Agradecemos sus comentarios. You know, podemos tratar de ayudarle también.
And keep in mind, if there's any additional information, you can also leave that, and they can also take your chart. And we do have 3 other speakers. And this is you all's meeting, so we want to be mindful of the community's time allotted. But thank you so much.
Okay, you can leave your information. Hay otros 3 oradores que también tenemos.
¿Me pueden solo dar un minuto? Necesito decirles algo más.
Yeah, can you give me 1 more minute? I need to tell you something else.
Últimamente se está diciendo que se están robando muchos niños.
Lately, it's been saying that a lot of kids have been stolen or kidnapped?
¿Cómo se sentirían todos si uno de ellos es su hijo?
How would you feel if one of them was your child?
Por favor, ayúdenos a hablar con consejeros con nuestros hijos en la escuela.
Help us to, that our children are able to talk with counselors in the schools.
Todos tenemos hijos.
We all have children.
Es todo. Gracias.
That's everything. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Next speaker.
Good morning, President Rogers, Vice President Wyatt, board members, Deputy Superintendent Volkmer. I am Ashley Bidas-Alcala, president of the San Bernardino Teachers Association. And just a couple of comments that I wanted to add on behalf of the 3,000 educators who are working today in their classrooms and their school sites with our youth. Under strengths of the district, you have listed involved stakeholders. Over the past 9 years, we have seen a shift in the way that we do business around making decisions in the district. And we have built a strong communication pipeline between how we work with our district administration and our leadership within the unions of this district. And we would hate to see that falter at this point. We'd also like to see it improved because we can always get better. We can always improve our communications around decisions that are being made. And it's very important, as you've put under desired characteristics, that we continue to have someone who is open, who is very transparent, and approachable when dealing with all of us. Also, it's extremely important that when those decisions are made, that they consider our input, and that we are not just a seat at the table, but actually a thought partner, a critical friend, in those decisions that are being made. And we appreciate the board's attention to our relationship with the district. I know there's been a lot of labor strife in education that we've seen over the past year. Our neighbors to the west, Los Angeles Unified, have had a very tumultuous time with their current superintendent. I'd hate to see that happen in this district. We want to continue the established relationships that we have with you and also with whoever takes over to lead us into the next decade. So thank you for your time, and we look forward to being part of this process.
Thank you. And our last speaker.
Buenos días.
Good morning.
Soy Josefina Pérez.
I'm Josefina Pérez.
Tengo cuatro hijos. Una de mis hijas está en la universidad. Ya va a tomar su máster. Se llama Mayra Ceballos.
Okay, I have four children. One of my daughters is in college and is working on her master's.
La situación por la que estoy aquí es por las necesidades que mi hija ha tenido. Ella está en Arroyo Valley. Desde muy pequeña tuvo necesidades especiales que no... Batallé mucho para que le dieran ayuda.
Okay, I'm here because one of my daughters is in Arroyo Valley. She's had special needs, and it's been hard for her to get her needs met.
Es poco tiempo apenas el que ya le están dando la ayuda, pero agradezco grandemente que haya sido posible eso.
Okay, it's just been for a little while that she's been getting the help that she's needed, but I really appreciate that.
A veces uno viene a pedir la ayuda y no sabe a dónde y no le informan a dónde tampoco.
Okay, sometimes people ask for help, but they don't tell them where they're able to get that help.
A veces solamente dicen, vaya con fulana, y nadie hace nada.
Okay, sometimes they say, you need to go see such and such a person, but nobody does anything.
Y es muy frustrante eso.
And that's very frustrating.
Para uno de padre.
For a parent.
Tengo un nieto en Richardson que también ha tenido muchos problemas, el hijo de mi hija Mayra.
I have a grandchild at Richardson has also had lots of problems.
Pues eso ya va caminando ahí, gracias a mi hija también que todo el tiempo está ahí, que se informa y que está siempre pendiente de las necesidades de mi nieto.
Okay, and thanks to my daughter, she's been very attentive to his needs and have been trying to see that he gets his help.
Los niños con necesidades especiales necesitan trato también y no quieren que los desechen, sino que los ayuden. Muchas veces no los quieren ayudar.
Okay, special needs children need help. They just don't need to be put to the side, and not a lot of times they want to give them the help that they need.
A veces quieren que los cambien de escuela.
Sometimes they want to change them from school, change at schools.
Eso no es justo porque sería como cambiar a un enfermo de cama y sigue enfermo, ¿verdad?
It's, it'd be just like moving somebody who's sick from one bed to another, but he's still sick.
Yo creo que deben de proveer ayuda también a veces para los padres. Hay muchas necesidades en los padres. Pienso que si tenemos padres sanos.
Yes, also the parents need to be given help or attention, because if we have healthy parents,
vamos a tener hijos, niños y jóvenes sanos también.
We'll have children and youth that are healthy also.
Nosotros queremos lo mejor para nuestra comunidad. Yo tengo muchos años aquí y voy a seguir aquí.
Yeah, we want the best thing for our community. I have been here for a long time.
Hablando del nuevo director, nosotros queremos una persona.
Speaking about a new superintendent, we want a person
que verdaderamente le importen nuestros intereses.
That our interests are important to him.
Sobre todo que ame la comunidad, que ame nuestros hijos.
Que, that he would love our community, that he would love our children.
Que ame su trabajo.
That would love his job.
Que sea su pasión.
Que that would be his passion.
Que no le importen los ceros, nada más que vayan en su, a su cuenta.
That it isn't not important how much he gets paid.
Que verdaderamente se involucre.
That he would be involved.
En las necesidades.
In the needs.
Porque se debe trabajar como equipo.
Because he needs to be able to work as a team.
La comunidad.
With the community.
Juntamente con el distrito.
Along with the district.
Con las escuelas.
With the schools.
Con nuestros niños.
With our children.
Y nuestros jóvenes.
And our youth.
Queremos alguien que verdaderamente vaya a hacer grandes cambios positivos para nuestra comunidad.
We want somebody who's able to make truly large changes for the good of our community.
Es todo. Muchas gracias.
That's everything. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Thank you to everyone for staying and laboring with us. I think this was a great input, so we appreciate you. Again, as we said, tonight we will be back at 5:30, and we also invite you to go to the website. If there's additional information that you would like to put on the website, you can also do that.
Madam President, just wanted to know, are all these commentaries going to be placed on the website? And also, I would like to have them translated into Spanish as well. Dr. Volkmer?
We can certainly do that. It wasn't our plan to do that. Our plan was to bring all of that back, all of this information, as well as the information we've gathered from all of our, we've had over 200 website responses, bring that back to the board on June 30th, your next meeting.
Yes, that was going to be what we, they were compiling that, all
so
this
that you
for
could
us.
Consider all that. So it's
so the community
you.
Has given the input,
okay, but
we're
not
going to look at
it. Are we going to let them look at all the input?
He meant January 30th.
I'm sorry, what did I say?
Well, we were compiling January off 30th. Of them,
oh,
you know,
okay.
So that's a decision we can discuss, but it really was for our purposes.
Okay.
Because they, you know.
Oh, it's for our purpose?
It was for our
okay.
purpose.
I just wondered if the community would like to see everything.
I mean, it's.
Maybe we could talk about it.
And yeah. we can. Okay. All right, so thank you to everyone, and this meeting is adjourned.